Hi everyone, my name is Alexis Zerafa, and I'm a mixed media artist and AR developer. I've been creating with Lens Studio for the past 6 years, and it was my introduction to social augmented reality, which ultimately completely changed my career trajectory and my life. I like to build silly and lighthearted experiences, but I also like to tinker with use cases that provide utility, and I've recently started augmenting my physical artwork, like using my pottery as a target image to stick on digital extensions of my work. Besides using Lens Studio as a creative outlet for art and fun, I started making branded work in Lens Studio back in 2018 when I was still in university. My very first pitch included a questionable looking chicken tender with sunglasses, and it didn't get picked up by the client. But I stuck with it and I now work full time in AR development. Today, I'd like to talk about how I made AR my career, how you can make AR your career, and give actionable and practical advice on how to get started right away. Regardless of your background and existing skills, you can use Lens Studio to kickstart your professional journey into AR and AR development. So let's dive in. There are many challenges to learning a new medium, but I can honestly say, at least for me personally, I think one of the hardest parts is gaining the confidence to start. The best advice I can give is to jump right in, have fun with it, and don't put unnecessary expectations on yourself. I started tinkering with different AR programs and game engines when I was in university. One of the first projects I made was an augmented business card, but all that happened was a little 3D dog appeared on top. I really enjoyed building little digital experiences that I could ground in my physical environment, but the development process was a little tough for me, and at that time I was having trouble envisioning what else I could do in this medium. Funny enough, my first ever lens on Snap used the same clunky 3D model, and you can try it here on my old profile. Before that, I loved making photo and video collages, compositing different images and videos over each other to make something cool and new. I slowly began to realize AR was just like that, but in real time. I found Lens Studio right before I graduated and was delighted by how quick the development process could be. It was also amazing to be able to share my work directly to Snapchatters without the hassle of uploading an app for review and loading one onto people's phones. In just a few clicks, my work went from my computer right onto a huge platform that I was already using. Once I found the courage to start learning AR development, I quickly gained momentum and built my skills by working on projects that I was passionate about. For me, the fastest way to learn something new is based on project-based learning. By having an end goal as a North Star and being driven by something specific, instead of trying to pick up general skills, I'm able to work more efficiently and retain information better. Even today, if I see a lens that I think is really cool, I may try to reverse engineer it and figure out how it was built. Or better yet, I could find specific tutorials and resources on how to do something similar and follow those, but while putting my own spin on it in order to learn and grow my skills. It's easier to work on things that you care about, so trying to build something you know you would use is always a great start. As a personal example of that, I wanted to learn more about location-based AR experiences. I participated in a local New York City art fair and utilized the Flatiron Landmarker template to make a submission based on augmenting that building. Even though I kept the lens concept simple, I learned a lot and in a short amount of time. Once you have a few ideas for what you'd like to build, you'll need to start gathering skills and learning the platform. Luckily, there's an amazing community behind Lens Studio and a ton of resources out there. When I first started using Lens Studio, the SnapAR platform was just beginning. There were very few resources available and even fewer community-created tutorials. I found myself powering through on my own, fueled by lots of snack breaks. Today, there's a wealth of amazing resources to help you learn Lens Studio regardless of your background. In the new SnapAR Learn Hub, you can find all of the SnapAR learning content in one place. I'd recommend the Lens Studio Starter Kit videos on the SnapAR YouTube channel to start. This will get you acquainted with the software and the general flow and guide you through the steps to build your first lens. There's also a Discord channel for the SnapAR platform where you can search for already posted solutions or ask new questions, and it's an amazing place to connect with other creators and share ideas. With all types of learning materials and the community to support you, you're in a great spot to get started. And remember, as with anything new that you're learning, the most important thing is simply to be persistent, stay curious, and stick with it. I know for me, it can be really enticing to give up on something if I'm not immediately good at it. But some of my favorite hobbies and creation mediums today are things that I was really bad at initially. Carving out dedicated time to work on Lens Studio projects is a great way that I create a schedule for myself and stick with it. And subscribing to the YouTube channel is key to staying in the loop for upcoming live streams. Another good tip is that you rarely ever need to start from zero. Templates are your friend. New lens templates are released all the time in Lens Studio. These templates can be used as a starting point for your lens or a great reference to help you understand how a certain type of lens can be built. Let life inspire you, and don't be afraid to try and fail. The most important thing is that you're creating. I share that because it's exactly how I made AR creation my career, and I want to share my journey with you today. I think for most, starting on a new path in your life doesn't happen at a single pivotal point. It happens over time. I'd love to be able to say that I went all in on AR the second I first touched Lens Studio, but in reality, it was more of a slow burn for me. I graduated, started a career pretty unrelated to AR, but I continued to make personal projects. Eventually, I had made enough work and championed my own projects enough to gain some traction, and I got a sprinkling of inquiries about making AR experiences for others. My very first freelance client project was a simple photo booth style project for $250, which for you aspiring creators out there is not a good rate, but you do need to start somewhere. On that note, one great way to develop your professional portfolio on top of personal projects is to create branded lenses. By partnering with companies and brands, you can create amazing work, collaborate with others, and get paid for your creations. It can be intimidating to reach out to brands, but you can create sample lenses to show them the value of AR and your work. I recommend creating lens concepts for brands you're interested in working with, connecting with local businesses to see if they'd be interested in using lenses as a new way to reach customers, or even make lenses for your friends' special events or occasions. You can also apply to open calls for art or artistic residencies. Occasionally, Snap will host their own residencies for lens creators, which is a great opportunity to aspire towards and an amazing environment to learn and grow your skills. I was fortunate enough to be able to participate in the Spotlight Lens Residency. The Spotlight team empowered me to basically create whatever I wanted, with the end goal being to create lenses that have the potential to perform well on Spotlight. And I had so much fun seeing projects from other residents and getting notes and plus-ups from an amazing and supportive group. If you're watching this session, I hope you've discovered your passion for augmented reality and want to find meaningful work within the space. Regardless of where you are in your AR journey, it's a good time to consider your long-term goals and consider the types of opportunities available to you. In my experience, I've seen peers and friends find success both when starting their own AR business or finding full-time AR developer positions. When I started, my goal was to build up a strong enough repertoire of work with freelance clientele to be able to snag a full-time job. I made sure to create a variety of projects from AR games to try-ons, world-scale work, and a lot of selfie lenses. It's also good to note that augmented reality roles are not only development-focused. Project managers, artistic and creative directors, 3D modelers, and more are needed in the professional space to build out these awesome experiences. So even if development isn't for you, your interests and skills could still fit within the AR vertical. There are different benefits to both freelance and full-time work, so it is important to do some self-reflection on what your wants and needs are. Freelance work tends to have more flexible hours because you can set them yourself and you can control what projects you're working on and when. Full-time work typically allows you to work with a team and collaborate with others, consistently with more set hours and a set schedule. So it's fully up to you to curate what your goals are and milestones are. But it's important and always helpful to reach out to other creators in the space and ask them about how they got to where they are today and if they have any advice on choosing a path. We as creatives should exist to lift each other up and grow together. And as you learn and grow, you can pay that knowledge forward as well. Unfortunately, there's no secret sauce to putting yourself out there and getting your work recognized. It's all about persistence and consistency. A good place to start is to identify the type of work and projects that you want to do and build those types of experiences. As you create more projects, you'll naturally start to build a portfolio. You can host this work on a website, but I know firsthand how daunting it can be to keep a portfolio website updated. To lower that barrier to entry, you can use your Snap profile as a place to showcase all of your awesome lenses. Integrating and using Snap codes within other areas is great as well because it allows people to experience what you've made instantly. It's also very important to be proactive. Typically, work won't find you. You have to find the work, so searching for open roles that include Lens Studio or social augmented reality in the keywords is one place to start. Reaching out to brands with ideas for lenses and activations and applying to open calls with an augmented reality pitch in mind are also great ways to potentially find new projects and opportunities. The most important advice I can give is simply to be patient. Progress doesn't typically happen overnight, and it took me many years to get to a place where I could confidently call myself a full-time AR developer. All that matters is that every day your work is a little better than it was yesterday, and that you're proud of yourself and your accomplishments. That's still how I approach my work today. In the office and on my passion projects, I'm always striving to try my best to push the boundaries of what I can create. My aspiration for the year ahead is to focus more on installation work and augmenting my physical creations, as well as expanding more into web-based AR. To work towards that goal, I applied to get access for Camera Kit, which will allow me to bring my AR creations I make in Lens Studio to the web. Camera Kit brings the power of Snap's AR platform to your websites and mobile apps on iOS and Android. I'm really excited to get creative with how I integrate AR directly into my website and to rethink my creation pipeline to make experiences that extend to Snapchat, websites, and spectacles. If you're not yet familiar, spectacles are Snap's AR glasses. When you put them on, they allow you to see and interact with AR experiences with your hands and voice. I'm personally so excited about spectacles and AR wearables because I love making experiences that provide utility. It's a lot easier to ideate on a practical experience when the user can have their hands completely free. Because lenses for spectacles are also made in Lens Studio, you're able to use the same skills you've learned when building lenses for Snapchat to create for this new device. An amazing example comes from Alex Brandt's team at Mousepack. Their Jar Smash spectacle experience is so incredibly fun and well executed, and this is the type of experience that I aspire to create for AR glasses. I'm so thankful that I get to do what I love and be creative every single day. Platforms like Lens Studio allow me to bring my ideas to life, I can quickly prototype and pump out projects before I inevitably get distracted with all of my other crafts and hobbies. That's the beauty of Lens Studio. It's so easy to get started, and anyone with any skill level can learn to make lenses. If you stick with it and commit to learning, you can use this program as a vehicle to kickstart your career in augmented reality. I hope this talk has helped guide your creation journey even just a little bit, and thank you so much for tuning in.